everyone. I wanted to do a video today on safety and fear, the acronym false evidence appearing real. The second people find out that I live in an RV full time and I travel by myself, there are two comments that I get. The first one is, I've always wanted to do that. That's a whole nother video topic that I'll do one of these days. The second one is, by yourself? You're so brave. And that's what I want to talk about today. Yeah, that is kind of unusual for a female to do, but there's a lot of you out there. Oops. There's a lot of you out there right now doing that. So I don't think it's all that unusual. I think it's important to really kind of break it down what fear is to a certain extent. But my experience is that it really is just letting the unknown guide my life. And there's a lack of abundance and trust in that acronym. So with that in mind, I also think our society, I think the movies out there, the videos, everything, the news, it all plays into this. I mean, the government, that's a whole nother topic, but it all plays into this sort of fear concept. And my theory on that is that life is meant to be lived. And if I feel guided or called to do something and I'm not doing it out of, you know, false evidence appearing real, then I am not making the most of my time here. Now moving into the actual tangible side of it. So I would say that I feel safer in my RV than I have ever felt in a home. There have been moments when I've been traveling about that, I think I've been hanging around a bunch of Canadians traveling about, when I have definitely not felt totally safe, but I'm very aware of those moments and I listen to them. In fact, one time when I was driving over the Grapevine in California, it was getting late and I just wanted to crash somewhere. So I looked for a Walmart and I pulled into the Walmart and, I felt uncomfortable and I thought, you know, I'm never going to fall asleep in this kind of state. So I went into Walmart and I typically do this whenever I would stay at a Walmart or stay anywhere like that. I would go ask them and I would say, I am a single female by myself. Am I safe here? And that kind of ties in with the question that I get asked. I guess I fed into that a little bit. People would always be really honest with me. And sometimes I would say, would you let your sister or your daughter stay here? And so I kind of get a grasp. So if I'm getting uncomfortable vibes, I would go in and ask. And most of the time, they would tell me that I was just fine. There was one that I felt really uncomfortable in that they told me that they would not stay in the parking lot. I got out of there. You know what I realized? I realized that I was in East LA. There's songs about East LA. So, you know, my intuition, my feeling was justified. My experience in an RV is that it's so small and, you know, in a home, there's so many nooks and crannies that someone could hide and break in. Whereas in an RV, unless your RV is just sitting out in the middle of nowhere and you're not in there attending it, I don't think anyone would bother you ever. And on top of it, my bathroom's in here. I don't really have to leave, and it's really the nighttime that I would ever not feel safe. Another thing I would say about living in an RV and safety is that the community. I mean, look at all of everybody here. Everybody's so supportive and helpful, and I have I've always stayed in RV parks. Well, no, that's not true. I mean, I've stayed at Walmarts and I've stayed in a lot of different places. But I would say that the RV community, the trucking community, even the truckers, I feel really safe with too. Are very supportive of each other, and there's just sort of a feeling of camaraderie amongst everybody, even though people tend to a lot of times keep to themselves. I always feel like if there were any kind of issues that I would have all these people on my back, you know, or they'd get my back. And in times that I've not felt safe, there's probably been a handful of them. What I've done is I've slept with my key fob in my hand, finger on the panic button. I've never needed it, but I have definitely had that in place if I have needed it. Or, you know, I've had that as sort of a comfort for myself. So the last point I would like to make is that I believe in my heart of hearts that most people out there are good. And I do think that that translates in whether or not I am a candidate to be attacked. Because one of the strategies, I actually have traveled a lot in my lifetime. In fact, I traveled by myself with a backpack through Europe, and I slept in train stations, and I slept in on park benches. I mean, I slept in crazy places. Europe was a little bit different at that time. But anyway, what I found is that if I feel uncomfortable with someone walking towards me or around me, and what I would do is I would make eye contact with them. I would make eye contact with them, and I would smile. And the reactions I've received are all over the place, but I do believe that it kind of sends a message to them that I know your heart of hearts, you're a good person, and I don't know, I think that that changes people's perspective. I think a lot of times attackers and people like that are hurt. I mean, they are just going through life as best they know how. And so I guess that's how I try to operate my life. It's not a perfect science. It's not every single time it's like that. But I think that holding that belief in people and trust in people, you know, I think that that makes a difference in my feeling around safety.